What's my line? Oh, I did this video for the halibut. I can't be coy with this. Let's talk about fishing games.
Come on, beach! It's Sonic Speed!
The calm air, the open waters. Fishing has been a part of human culture for thousands of years. A task requiring precise knowledge of the flow and movement of water, how fish travel at different times of year, a battle of patience and senses. Jump forward in time, paradigm shift, now we're drawing fish with boobies! Both a technological and literary marvel. When it comes to video games, they try to adapt everything. Sports, board games, boarding schools, and schooling boys in the slam jam! Fishing games are a bit of an enigma to me. Because video games, like, where you start, it's usually objective-based, you know? As you're playing the game, you're doing things within the game to reach your objective. Sonic, you're running and jumping, overcoming enemies to get to the signpost. Tetris, you're trying to match blocks in order to keep the game going for as long as possible. In Persona 5, you're going out with cute girls on dates to strengthen your relationship with them so you have new abilities within the turn-based battles. A video on this will happen eventually, alright? But fishing, you know, my line of logic is, the whole point of fishing is to actually catch the fish. It's like a reward, and the only way you feel that satisfaction is if you're holding that goddamn fish. Slime and grime all over your dime. So translating that to video game form is taking away the only reason you would do it in the first place. Well, this only dawned on me because my half-dad, Deon, wanted to take us out on a fishing trip, and I wanted to see if the fake fishing in games was the same as the real thing. So with our worms hanging freely, we set out to the open waters.
Ooh, wow, Deon, you look fresher than fresh. What?
Get a good shot of the shoes. Get a good shot of the shoes.
Ready to catch some fishes?
Oh, I was born ready.
To catch fish?
To catch fish.
That's f***ing pretty lame.
Now we've been out here for a while, and still no bites. Lucky for them, I have some research notes I packed of all the fishing games I played before the trip. Okay, let's get the elephant out of the room. It's no contest that Sega's Bass Pro Fishing is one of the best to adapt fishing in-game form. They even had this fishing controller peripheral for the Dreamcast, and from what I hear from people playing it, it's actually, like, accurate and fun. And this is probably because of the arcade remnants left within the game. But all in all, it's solid and dynamic. For fishing, they actually managed to adapt it well.
Now that's a fish.
Thanks. So there was this recent game as well, Rapala Fishing Pro Series, and it's actually not that bad either. It's a solely fishing-dedicated game, and surprisingly, it looks like a fun time. When I think about fishing in games, the first series that comes to mind is Zelda. And each of the entries in the series all have their own answers to the age-old question of game design. How do we best slow down the pace of the game to a standstill? Ocarina of Time was at least inoffensive. You just lock on and cast out your reel and put it near an area with fish. And I mean, you do it for like a piece of heart when you're a kid and then you come back when you're an old man. And smaller fish are actually easier to catch. One of that relates to real life. And the only other time is when you need to get into Lord Jabu Jabu's belly by putting a fish in front of him so he can eat it. Wind Waker, for being all about water, has like two things remotely related to fishing. So once you hear the ocean's ringtone, you actually just crane down and you can get some treasure. And then the only other fish is this guy. But all he does is mark your sea chart. And I guess you do technically catch him. You throw out this unmarked, unbranded bait into the water. Although I wish it was that easy.
Live bait.
The only bait that's live here is you, my friend.
But me and my sister play this game. We used to call him Speck because he goes. But we were always confused why you couldn't eat him because he's looking like a snack. Twilight Princess forces you to fish many a time in the game with the majesty of the Wii motion controls. Oh man, do you want to experience your unresponsive and dissatisfying last relationship? Because I sure do. And the worst part is, man, at the beginning of the game, the tutorial for this is so damn clunky. You may have your opinions on it, but I mean, this was such a buzzkill. I was expecting Zelda, like, oh yeah, oh yeah. But sit him here like, okay, you know, if I'm gonna better shit to do fucking shit. At least you get to fish with a girl later. Remember that? I didn't. After the Sky Zelda, there was Breath of the Wild. Fishing is absolutely perfect in this game. dinner is dead. A whole ecosystem is dead. I think many of the Zelda games turned me away from fishing just because of how much it halted the gameplay. And it's never like obvious what you have to do to catch the fish. You just put the thing in and wiggle it and it's like, okay, I got it, maybe. Even if I am complaining, it doesn't take nearly as long to catch a fish in these games compared to the real deal.
But anyway, fishing in games.
Huh?
What I was getting at is
getting?
Fishing in games, you cast the line in and then like 2 seconds later it's like, oh, you got a bite.
Yeah.
Yes. Yeah, not like real life
at all. Like that.
No, it's not like that at all.
You wouldn't think.
Probably knew that.
Many of my other experiences with fishing games are heavily limited to stuff like Mario Party, where it's just... Yep, that's... Oh, well, if you remember that N64 controller's analog stick, gee whiz. You needed to flick the control stick ever so gently in order to cast your line out, except it's mega sensitive. You hit this thing and it's always gonna overshoot. And it's always just the shameful reel right back in. Everyone's laughing at you. I much prefer the other ones where you have to wait for a rumbling line in order to pull it out because it's more fucking accurate than this shit. So I mean, these are the few fishing games I've played. I get fish and chips and that's enough of the Maritimes. So I had to dig a little deeper. There has to be some more advanced fishing tech that I can learn from some other games. But like Nier Automata, really? It's simply you get resources that you eventually can sell. Even Warframe has it. This has to be the funniest by far. You're just aiming your crosshair and going spearfishing. This is like me when I'm getting sushi and I go in panic mode because I'm afraid I'm gonna drop it. Like, ah! Far Cry 5, you actually cast out in reel, opposing the fish's movements by moving the analog stick. Final Fantasy 197 is one of the most dynamic I've seen. For one, the fish actually has a health meter that you dwindle down by doing quick time events of pushing the controller in the right direction. You also need to make sure the tension of the line doesn't get too red. So lots to think about for just catching a fish. And it looks like anime is about to pay off. Wait, that's a fish! There's a fish on the line! What's he calling for? I hate those agencies, they just call you for nothing.
I hate those fishing emails.
Thank you, Paul.
Don't let it come out of the water. It will break the line.
Hey, sunfish.
Pumpkin seed.
I didn't even have it on my line. I was literally gonna reel it back. I'm like, oh, I think I got my worm.
Oh, he's a cool looking guy.
They are spiky. Pain in the ass to get off the hook.
What are they?
They're called sunfish or pumpkin seeds.
See? They hurt like a bitch. Touch it.
I don't wanna, it's scary! I would never touch such a vile creature, are you kidding me? That's why I've got you here.
It seems like, although fishing is still a minigame in most games, they're actually refining it to be something that's at least enjoyable to pull.
Now that's where I draw the line, done being a YouTuber, vacation for the next 2, 5, 6, 8 years.
Pigs fishing sections are something else. I had some kid at a con try and tell me, oh, it wasn't that bad, it's only 10 minutes you have to spend in a level. Excuse me? 10 minutes? I don't know what peanut butter and jelly ass 10 minutes you have because I have to go to work. People work these days. I'm trying to eat, not catch these fake ass frog fish. So for the uninitiated, Sonic Adventure had multiple character stories, Sonic Adventure Review! He good, he's just a Sonic, good Emerald Radar, Well, the gameplay for this one was actually pretty cool, and it told a complex story of a robot beginning to learn how to love and if his emotions are actually real. And then this. Bro, if the frog is leaving you so much, maybe you should get the hint that it doesn't want to be around you. Big's fishing sections have you going through 4 action-packed fishing locales, where you throw your reel in and... wait. And it's not enough to just fish, you have to find where the frog is, go there, and hope he bites!
So, we're out on the water, still, and I think, Big the Cat's fishing for Froggy would still take longer? You think?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I've played through Sonic Adventure's story maybe 3 times in entirety, and still to this day, there's no method to this madness. I just hope and pray that I get it.
And it seems if Paul was emulating any fishing style,
whew. Don't worry, Paul, you'll catch a fish.
Shut up.
Well, I guess you're not catching a fish with that attitude. The fish can sense deceit. It can sense greed.
I'll beat you with this fishing rod.
Yes, but you still won't have any fish.
So from everything we've learned from throwing your line, wiggling your rod, reeling while maintaining tension, hey, it seems like Deon's got a bite!
Catfish? No way! Catfish Yo, bruh.
Reel it in a little more.
I can't. It's too heavy. I can't even. I can't even reel it in.
How you doing, buddy?
Yeah. Oh shit. I feel like a titan right now. Just like.
I'm a stupid fucking fish.
As much as I like fishing, I don't like it when it ends up getting stuck like this because it's really, especially catfish, he's like, he's literally making like noises and shit.
Well, Peter,
hold it up.
It was absolutely quicker than catching Froggy.
Yep.
Do you guys want to put water in it?
No, I want it dead.
You fucking monster!
I'm gonna eat it. I think the biggest difference is in games, it's a game. But real fishing, you feel connected with nature, with the water, with the tugging of the fish on your line. There's nothing that beats the real experience. And not only for the activity, but the time you get to spend with friends.
I guess, Deon, that you could say friendship, like fishing, is off the hook.
Fish belong in water, or our stomachs. Not in games. Except that one. Alpha rats and stars, Sudoku, Jubs, and yes, and John Palomares, Gay is Ben Squared, Zandaroni, the Panther, Stephen Temple, the Pleb, Ford, Sabrina, Metairie, Aki Jackson, Bobby Lopez, Scott Brown, Silver, Bob, Richard, Katoto, Taylor, Wallace, Dean, Commu, Monero, Karen, Ward, David Plavitsky, Brendan, Lewis, Kassar, Ethan, Ed Benson, Rad Hat, Chloe, Carducci, Ryan, Monsieur. Now we're moving on to the really hard part. The Duke, Adore, Bulbonic, Plague. Don't sue me, Andrew Dunt, it's a minus. Jeff Badu, Scott Lang, the Barney, Brit for Ready, Hang Boy. I'm sorry if I missed your names last time. Jonathan Bigger. Nintendo, Dill Man, STM, DDDo, DDDDO, whatever you call. Juicy Curtilla, Jacqueline the Insane, Penny Herman, Deezus Bowler, Colin King, Mugden, Kina, Kim, Richard Large, BBT, Gecko, Desert Reliver, Jag, X, Yuzumaki, Samuel, Gerardo, Nico, Ray, Altamaki, Miles, Anderson, John, Kami, Ramu, Arsene, Maguire, Eclipsio, Xanon, Ryan, P, Stone, Wedgie, Ninja, a guy named Umana, Nakali, Malty, 1267899, Rambling, Camp, Buffy, the Clown, Carson, Thor's Burn, Zuckerberg, Yachting, Fedor, Rusak, Coyote, Lap, Willow, Bleak, and Fusion, Warrior, Mosher, Grady, Perrin, Sean, Gear, How Not, Human, Dave, Dark, Dad, James, Tur, 445, Jazz, Rent, Jason, Zilladon, $99, Man, Danny, DeVito, Liam, Tamani, Liam, Real, Daniel, DJ, Kushler, Jr., John, Michael, George, May, Weezy, Wheeler, oh my god, oh, I'm sorry, everyone, Afro, Fluff, Deck, Koopa, Miko, Gale, Bay, Man, from Kyle Nichols, Bobby Krizeros, Joseph Styles, Joseph Maiorelli, holy shit, it's Balls, and that guy in the store, Tail of the Toaster, Evan Fonte, Emmanuel, FYI, Pushe, and the Will, Karen of the Stars, Gramsci, Yen and Zoopy, Camo, Dustin Susie, Hylio, Jesse Thompson, Jeep Gaming, Priscilla Cardoso, Lane McCallum, Matthew Dobbins, Kazuki Jeff, Marlo Wowzers, Brad Penguin, Salty, Evil Eye, Quentin Salomon, Nathan, Brian Carter, Brady Charter, Nervion, Keith, Philip Guy Blinger, Eric Wise, Nathan Carter. Do you hear this? I cannot keep this pace. I couldn't keep this pace. Thank you all for your pledges. This is giving me mad anxiety. I need to. Whew. I think I'm only gonna do the new patrons for every month from now on, okay? $5 and up. Is that fair? Can that be fair? I'm out of here. Have a good night.